Seems like old times. And it is old times because we're back to where we were in some ways anyway, back to January. Can I just say that obviously Dr. Chant and I are here to talk about some of the measures that people can take to protect themselves in what is now a fairly challenging time in terms of COVID. Since the beginning of the year, we've had 1,232 people who've died of COVID-related issues, who had less than the full vaccinations that were available to them. That's a critical issue. Having your full dose of vaccinations that are available to you does make a difference. What we're seeing at the moment is BA4 and BA5 are increasing in the proportion of people who are getting COVID, and they're having an effect which is concerningly maybe similar to what we saw in January this year, when we had more than 6,000 staff furloughed out of our hospital system. And of course, who could forget that we also had many, many staff off from the major distribution centres for our major retailers, particularly around food, etc. We had many staff off in our hospitals. More than 6,000 staff were off in our hospitals, furloughed, on the 14th of January. We don't want to get back into that position. We also, of course, had substantially increased numbers in our hospitals, and we saw substantially increased deaths in January. Obviously, as I've said many times and Dr. Chant has said many times, there is no playbook when you're in a pandemic. We're learning as we go. The world is learning as we go. What we do know now is that getting fully vaccinated, whatever number of vaccinations you are eligible to get, does make a difference. Now, BA4 and BA5 are not, the vaccinations are not necessarily stopping transmission. So these rather pesky little variants are quite intelligent, and they're working their way around the current vaccines to an extent. Transmission is still happening. But what we do know is if we're fully vaccinated, we're far less likely to get as ill and far less likely to die. So the very important message that Dr. Chant and I are here to say today, and she'll give more detail, is if you haven't had your full doses, and most of the population know that you can have up to 3 doses, and then possibly 4 or even more if you're older and in certain circumstances with comorbidities, in other words, other serious illnesses, or perhaps you're immunocompromised. But if you've had 2, for example, or 1, and you haven't had your full 3, put it bluntly, you're crazy. You should go and get them, because that is what's going to make a difference to stopping or at least reducing the chances of you ending up in hospital or ending up possibly dying. I can't stress this enough. I think there are some in the community who are just very busy. There are others in the community who think the pandemic's over. On both of those counts, they're wrong. So I would strongly encourage, I mean, I know I have friends who've said to me that they're fully dosed, and when I ask the question, they've had 2 doses of vaccine. And as the health minister, I quickly tell them, go and get your 3rd dose. I would encourage everybody to be a mate to their mates in New South Wales, indeed across Australia. Ask, have you had your full 3 doses, or possibly 4 if you're older or got those comorbidities or other issues, immunocompromised? But ask your mates, have you had the full dose? Because if you do, you're going to be a lot safer. You're going to have far less likelihood of getting really ill and far less likelihood of dying. And that's, I think, true mateship in Australia during a pandemic. That's what we need to do. It's a simple question, but it could make a big difference. In addition to getting fully vaccinated, again, Dr. Chant and I spent many, many months talking about the need to wash hands, to stay home if you're ill, to do the basics. And I think that perhaps to some degree, because people have become a little, I don't know, is it apathetic? It's certainly, it's an overconfidence that the pandemic has come and gone. It hasn't, it's well and truly here. So please go back to those basic messages. Wear a mask if you can't socially distance, and definitely wash your hands and stay home. Wash your hands as much as you possibly can and stay home if you're sick. Don't go and sit in a theatre or in a footy match, particularly in internal facilities, anywhere. Don't go to a theatre if you're sick, because you're likely to be spreading it around. And of course, if you've got any symptoms at all, you should do a RAT, rapid antigen test, or get a PCR test. In addition to those basic measures, there's also, of course, one of the big pluses that we've got now that we didn't have last year, and that is antivirals. Antivirals at the moment are limited in their usage for a number of reasons, which I don't necessarily agree with. And Dr. Chant will have some more to say on this, but this obviously comes down to federal advisory bodies giving advice. I'm hopeful that the federal body that gives the federal government the advice will do what's necessary to make sure that antivirals are more accessible to a broader age group than currently is the situation. I understand that there may be some challenges in the formalities, and certainly I'm hopeful that that might be curtailed or at least circumvented, and we're having discussions with the federal government about those issues at the present time. So hopefully we'll see some announcements on that in the near course. But if you do actually get the virus, then certainly inquire positively about whether or not you're able to access an antiviral. Antivirals do make a difference. They definitely make a difference for the majority of people who actually get the COVID virus. Now I'm going to ask Dr. Chant to say anything that she'd like to say in more detail. Chant.
Thanks, Minister. And I'm just going to go over a few things that the Minister, to re-emphasise what the Minister has put forward. So we have started a new wave that is being driven by the new Omicron variants BA4 and 5, and we expect this wave to peak in late July and early August. We predict that hospitalisations will be similar to the BA1 wave in January, and there's lots of other viruses such as flu and RSV. So that's also a difference from what was occurring in January, where we hadn't seen those, that uptick in flu and RSV at that time. So I'm concerned about this picture, and I'm calling on the community to do a few things to protect yourself and each other. It's essential that you stay up to date with your vaccinations. ATAGI, the technical group that provides advice, is monitoring the situation all the time, and it may well update its advice. So what I would suggest is you monitor the situation closely, check your eligibility, and help those around you to know if they're eligible for additional doses. Isolate if you're sick and get tested. Wear a mask when indoors and around other people, and know if antivirals are recommended for you. So please wear a mask in indoor areas around other people outside of your home, including public transport, pharmacies and shops. Masks, whilst protecting yourself, can also protect other people. Stay at home if unwell with symptoms such as cough and runny nose, fatigue, tiredness, sore throat. And importantly, just because your RAT test is negative, do not go out and about. One, you may still have COVID because the RAT test is an imperfect test. Two, you could have flu or RSV, and let's not share those around either. Anyone who's experienced those understands that that's not pleasant either. So please stay at home if you're unwell, work from home, take those simple precautions. If you happen to be frail, elderly, or have severe underlying health conditions, I would urge everyone to try and get access to a PCR test. That's more reliable, and we do want you to be diagnosed early so you can avail yourselves of those antivirals. Please make sure that you know yourself if you're eligible for the antivirals. ahead of getting COVID, have a plan, and also help others and prompt them if they tell you they've got COVID, prompt them to check whether they are eligible for antivirals. We know that the information around antivirals is a little confusing, and as the Minister said, we're keen to work with our colleagues at the Commonwealth to see those messages simplified and transmitted more clearly. We also know that something simple like fresh air is important. So even though it's cold outside and pretty wet at the moment, please consider choosing well-ventilated areas for get-togethers, particularly if you're lunching or socialising with the frail elderly. And Sydney and other parts of the state have got those areas, undercover areas, outdoors, with heating. They're really good places to entertain, particularly the frail elderly or those with underlying health conditions. We need to make it clear that previously we did tell you to get two doses and that that would provide protection against COVID. But the virus has changed. So now with Omicron, the evidence is clear that we need three, or in some cases four, doses to provide the best protection against getting very sick. And as the Minister has said, what we know about the Omicron variants is that they're very good, that the vaccines are still good at protecting us against getting very sick when we're infected, but they're not so good at protecting us getting infected in the first place. So that's the issue the Minister was talking about in terms of their ability to reduce transmission or the spread of the virus. And this resonates with the community. You probably know yourself that people that are up to date that have been fully vaccinated, but we need to have a clear message that being up to date with your vaccinations is the best protection you can have to keep you getting very sick, requiring hospitalisation or dying. We also need to emphasise that you can get reinfected. So just because you've had Omicron in the BA1 wave in January, February, or this latest wave that we've experienced, which is a BA2 wave, it doesn't absolutely prevent you getting BA4 and 5 in the upcoming wave. So reinfection is possible. So again, that's important to get retested, know if you're eligible for antivirals, stay at home when you're sick, and don't assume that it isn't COVID. So we need to act now to slow the spread of the virus in the community. And I'm confident that as a community we can take those actions to slow the spread, as well as the individual actions of getting vaccinated, which fundamentally protects ourselves. This is important because when we have levels of sickness and absenteeism, it impacts on the broad community in terms of its access to goods and services, as we saw in January. So we all have a part to play, and by taking these simple steps, we can really slow the spread, and as I said, vaccination is key for that individual protection. So I call upon the community to act now, act promptly, get your vaccine, and to take the small steps